Hello there, folks. My name is Spunks, and I saw The Suicide Squad, and it was amazing. Believe me, when I heard not only were they going to reboot this franchise after the disastrous first attempt, but also get James Gunn to write and direct the movie, I was already on board, and the trailers made this movie look amazing, and thankfully, not only did it meet those expectations, it exceeded them. This is honestly, without a doubt, my favorite comic book movie of the year so far. First off, I thought the story was really engaging and really interesting. The movie tells its story out of order, similarly to Deadpool and Birds of Prey. And like those movies, I think this movie does it perfectly. It doesn't feel gimmicky, and it feels like it's based, like the reason for it to be told out of order, in a sense. And the story itself is also rather really well done. I like that it's much, for the most part of the movie, it's smaller scale. It's not like leading, it's not like overly dramatic or serious. It's lighthearted, but it's serious when it needs to be. It's that perfect balance. And it doesn't feel like it has to be this grand, bloated, dumb superhero movie. For the majority of it, it's just the characters searching for this government organization, and then near the climax, that's when it turns to like a big blockbuster movie. But I think the film works better this way because I can buy these characters actually doing a mission like this, as opposed to the other film where it's like, how are these goons going to accomplish this mission at all? This seems impossible. Where this movie, it seems very acceptable and very likely that these characters could accomplish something like this. Speaking of the characters, they're all likable and well-developed and very entertaining to watch. They all have a unique dynamic. Their backstories are really engaging. They have some witty banter and funny moments. And they're also three-dimensional and, like I said, well-developed. There are also some twists and turns revolving certain characters. Some things are revealed about some of them that caught me off guard, surprisingly, and James Gunn really meant it when he said don't get too attached, because there are certain character deaths that once again very surprised me. I was not expecting certain characters to end up the way they did in this movie. And by the way, yes, King Shark is the best movie. The action sequences in here are also really good. They're well shot, well choreographed. They're intense, leave you on the edge of their seat. Brutal to watch. I liked the use of practical effects. I thought it made the action scenes feel more grounded. But the use of CG, as usual in these superhero movies, was also really well done. The CG really blended in with the background and the world. And like I said, these action sequences are also very violent. I cannot stress this enough. This is a very violent movie. Lots of blood, lots of gore. I'd honestly say it's more violent than Deadpool. And I think that's what makes the action sequences work even more. That they were able to show this and put this in a big blockbuster movie like this actually adds to the positives on how these action scenes were able to work out so well. This movie is also hilarious. I laughed out loud numerous times throughout the film. There are so many good one-liners and sight gags, and the way the characters played off of one another and their witty banter with each other was hilarious. And even some of the violence actually adds to the comedy as well, because some of the violence is so over the top and so graphic that it ended up being really funny. I know that's kind of a sick and twisted thing to say, but some of it made me laugh. I laughed a lot throughout the film. And the last positive thing I can say about this movie is that the film is generally sweet and has a ton of heart in it. The movie finds ways to make you sympathize and care about the characters, and it slows down and take some time to let you get to know what the characters are going through. And it honestly leads to some touching, heartfelt moments that I honestly wasn't really expecting from a movie like this. Now, I'm not saying it's like Pixar levels. You're not going to like all your eyes over this movie. But I found a lot of it to be sweet and genuinely touching. Now, as for issues I had with this movie, it's not a whole lot, but I still have problems with it. The first issue is that, well, I found that some of the humor didn't land for me. There were a couple of running gags that went on for a little too long throughout the movie. You could have just ended it a little there. And there are some one-liners that didn't land, and some jokes went on, like certain running gags went on for too long. You could have cut them short and it would have been a lot funnier. And as for the climax, albeit I thought it was pretty cool and entertaining and weird and odd for the most part, it is basically another superhero movie climax where they just need to go to the city to fight the giant monster from destroying it and just damaging buildings and property all across the town. And I did feel that at some point during it, it felt like it was starting to drag, and they kept escalating the stakes to the point where I was going, okay, we need to wrap this up. This should have ended like a couple minutes ago. It was cool, but it's really starting to make this movie longer than it should. But with all that said, I still really loved this movie. The story is great, the characters are lovable, the action is intense, the violence is brutal, it's hilarious, and it's got a ton of heart. If you couldn't tell already, I found this to be a massive improvement over the 2016 Suicide Squad movie. This is definitely a worthy reboot. It's a lot, again, it's a lot better movie. I think you guys are going to dig the hell out of it. It's a ton of fun. If you got HBO Max, go see it. Or if you want to see it at the theater, definitely go check it out there. I think it's definitely worthy of the theatrical experience, in my opinion. And I definitely highly recommend that you guys go check this out. It is, in my opinion, a must watch. And those were my thoughts on The Suicide Squad. What did you guys think of it if you've seen it? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Comment down below and let me know. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you like this channel, hit that subscribe button. Follow me on all the social media links at the end of the video. And until next time, guys, stay sharp. I'm a fool to do your dirty work. Oh, yeah. I don't want to do your dirty work. No more. I'm a fool to do your dirty work. Oh yeah.